If you have ever wondered, how much money is enough money for my retirement? Well, you aren't alone. And if you couldn't figure it out, you are still not the only one. Most of us think about it, but very few actually plan out their retirement and work on it. Welcome to Fix Your Finances, Build Financial Wealth. If you want to build your financial wealth and fill your mind with the right information, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe for us to provide you with more valuable content. So without any further ado, let us get right into the video, shall we? It isn't easy to know precisely how much money you need to guarantee financial security during your retirement. That being said, it is not impossible to get a good estimate, which will then help you in knowing about how much money you need to reach your goal. Retirement involves a lot of planning, and it is a multi-step process that evolves over time. When working on your retirement plan, it's important to think about what your retirement will look like. You need to build a financial cushion that will help you have a comfortable, secure, and fun retirement. The fun part will definitely be you thinking about what you will do with all your retirement funds, and the boring part would be making that money for your retirement. Well, it doesn't have to be boring, and we are here to help you out with that. Figuring out how much money you need to retire is like one of those word problems from high school that still haunts you. If X equals your spending in retirement, Y equals your rate of return, and Z equals the number of years you will live, how much will you need to save, given that X, Y, and Z are all unknowable? When planning for retirement, the truth is that the earlier you start saving, the better off you could be, all thanks to the power of compound interest. When working on a retirement plan, it is very important for you to think about what your retirement life is going to look like. Are you all about spending quality time with your family and friends, or do you have plans that involve a lot of traveling and dining out at your favorite restaurants? What about your medical expenses? The most important question would be about your expenses after your retirement. Answering this question helps you to crack the code for the amount of money needed post-retirement, because this is where you cannot overestimate or underestimate the retirement. Of course, you also need to calculate inflation. An easy rule of thumb says that you will need about 70% to 80% of your pre-retirement income to lead a good retired life. That still does not crack the secret code. So it would be best if you broke down your expenses post-retirement that could include home management, vacations, healthcare, income tax payment, the money required to handle emergencies, etc. The retirement equation isn't unsolvable, but it's not a precise calculation either. You will have to revisit your retirement formula every now and then to make sure it's on track and be prepared to make adjustments if needed. Making yourself self-aware about your expenses will help you to get a clear picture of how much money you will need to retire. Let us help you crack the code for your retirement finances by discussing it in detail, shall we? 1. Assess your current situation. You may not like to admit that you are not well prepared for your retirement, but you need to assess your current financial status to create a plan that could help you out with your post-retirement finances. Some people would like to retire earlier so that they can dedicate the rest of their lives for something else. It could be something they are passionate about, like traveling or anything of that sort. So all of these must be taken into account when you are assessing your current situation and also with what you want to do after your retirement. The 4% rule is a popular way for investors to calculate how much they need to save to hit their retirement income goals. It's relatively simple. You need to add up all of your investments and then withdraw 4% of that total during your first year of retirement. In subsequent years, you adjust the dollar amount you withdraw to account for inflation. 2. How much will you spend? Retirement is expensive. As we discussed earlier, a good rule of thumb is that you'll need about 70 to 80% of your pre-retirement income when you leave your job. The 70 to 80% rule comes from the fact that you will no longer be paying payroll taxes towards Social Security. However, you may have to pay some taxes on your Social Security benefits, and you won't be putting in money into your 401k or other savings plan. Also, during your retirement, you will be saving a lot of money on your office commute, a lot of new clothes, and so many other bills that were once there when you were working. Most people post-retirement are looking forward to travel to foreign countries and experience new things, and things can get expensive during your travel. As long as you plan well for those expenses, you don't need to worry. Most people also forget to consider medical expenses. As you grow older, you will be spending more time with your doctors than ever before. And we know healthcare is not cheap either. Finally, there's the question of how much, if anything, you wish to leave to your children or charity. Some people want to leave their entire savings to their children, which is perfectly fine, but it requires a much higher savings rate than a plan that simply wants your money to last as long as you do. 3. Your income from your savings. Let's say you invested in businesses that pay you a good amount of money and you are still getting your profit percentage monthly. This means that you don't need to save up a lot of money from your primary source of income, let's say a 9-to-5 job. And if you have your investments in stocks and bonds, you never know what that can do for you in 20 to 30 years. Most people don't often keep 100% of their retirement savings in a single investment. While they might have part of their portfolio in stocks for growth of capital, they often have a part in bonds to cushion the inevitable declines in stocks. Additional income can come from so many places outside your savings, and you should take that money into consideration too. If you're fortunate enough to be covered by a pension plan, monthly income from that asset should be added. You can also tally up income from a part-time job while in retirement. The amount you need to retire could be reduced if you'll have additional streams of income in retirement, especially if a portion of that income will be tax advantaged. 4. Your life expectancy. Well, this is something nobody can give a specific answer to, but it's always good to consider the best case scenario here depending on your health conditions and other factors that might add up to it. Why we recommend you take the best case scenario is because if you think you will live up to 80 years and you save up only to live till 80, your 81st birthday is not going to be memorable. Unless you know you're in frail health, however, it's probably best to plan to live 25 years after retirement to age 90. 5. Assess your risk tolerance. Risk tolerance is not the same, and it is different at different stages of your life. As you grow older and approach your retirement age, you will notice that your portfolio allocations will gradually turn more conservative in order to preserve the wealth that you have accumulated over the years. Retirement portfolios during this stage should be high quality, dividend-paying stocks and investment-grade bonds that produce both conservative growth and income. Investors that are willing to take the high-risk route often find themselves in a worse situation by committing to riskier assets at the wrong time. So it is very important that you have an idea about your risk tolerance. Retirement is an important reality for all of us, but at times, it is very easy to lose track of your long-term goal. When you are planning for your retirement, it's always good to start as early as possible for best compounding returns and not to rely heavily on a single source of savings. Because, let's face it, emergencies can happen at any time, and you have to face it. So by having a sufficient amount of money to deal with all these is crucial for your retirement to be pleasant. Also, everyone's retirement incomes and needs are going to be slightly different. To calculate your own retirement savings number, you need to carefully think through your potential income streams and your anticipated expenses during your retirement. Or, if you'd like personalized expert retirement guidance, you may want to consider setting up an appointment with a financial planner in your locality. If you think you have saved very little for your retirement, you need to think of this as a wake-up call to get serious about turning things to your advantage. It is better to tighten your belt now than be forced to do it when you are in your 80s. With that, we have come to the end of our video. Let us know in the comments below how much money you want to achieve for retirement. And make sure to subscribe and follow us on Instagram at fixyourfinances_. See you next time at Fix Your Finances.